like that.
Man, that's good value.
And what was it?
Dude. Oh, dude. Well done.
There it is. There
well done.
There and the wine itself.
Hey guys, welcome back to another week of blind wine tastings here at Wine for the People. Big thank you as always to Different Drop for sorting us out with these three wines that we're tasting this week. Now, as always, they've put them into a little bracket and it's a bit of a game that we've got to play. Apparently the game this week is Spot the Aligoté. It's one of my favorite games growing up as a kid. Used to play it at school all the time, so I feel like I'm gonna do really well here. If you would, please like and subscribe. It really helps the channel out. And if you're really interested in what we're doing here, hop down in the Discord. There's a link in the description to the video. It's this really cool community of about 400 wine lovers, and we just sort of talk shit about how I'm bad at tasting wines, to be honest with you. But other than that, let's hop into this week's video.
Let's rock and roll. Wine number one. A cloudy number that looks like it's been naturally settled, so it wouldn't surprise me if it's a more of a hands-off winemaker. Straight away, I'm just like, probably not the Aligoté.
This is one from Different Drop. You guys are bastards. A day. I understand that you've been paying attention and re-watching old videos. This is just mean. But I'm excited. I think it's gonna be fun.
Very green, this wine. And Aligoté is either quite often green or quite often not green. Let me know in the comments below.
Damn, that's good. Shit, that's good. Amazing sort of broad front palate, really giving a lot of depth and richness and sort of definition from the oak, but it's really held tight with this back palate acidity that really kind of makes my head go straight to Chenin Blanc.
I love the texture, decent acidity. Oh, has a little bit of that kind of custard apple-y thing, some nuttiness. Oh yeah, I like this. I really like this.
I don't particularly like it. It's a bit flat on the palate. For me, I'm looking for more fun in my wine.
I've had a wine like this quite recently by a producer called Sigurd, which blew my freaking mind. And this is kind of blowing it as well. I would drop $45 a bottle in this and I'd buy 12. I don't think it's the Aligoté, but I think it's a really, really good wine.
Alrighty, number two. Such a good wine. Number two, again, that kind of orchard fruity color.
Beautiful wine, classically made. Not a lot of oak influence either, but it is very closed. The predominant smell here really is batonnage.
I might not like Aligoté, as it turns out, because I haven't liked either of these wines particularly. Whew, what's that doing? It's a little bit cardboardy.
Great unctuousness and sort of juicy crispness as it sort of progresses through the palate with an almost a underripe pear powderiness to the tannin and structure. Quite an underrated little wine. Like you kind of don't expect that to happen, but then, wow, we've got all this like thrill and interest on the palate.
Last wine, looking a bit more like classic white.
It smells a little bit like the top of a creme brulee. It's like toasted, creamy, sweet thing, which I'm about.
It's very appealing. You know, if you're into that sort of thing, if you're into these sort of savory style of white wines, textural white wines, I do find this really appealing.
I think this is the Aligoté. I think number three is the Aligoté. It is my least favorite, but I think it's a very well put together wine. Definitely some classy making behind it.
It's lean, it's fresh. It doesn't taste how it smells. I was expecting something overtly more unctuousness, but this has the palate shape of what I would associate with Aligoté. I'd drop $48 a bottle on this. I'd buy 12 because I think it's a delicious wine. And I do think that is the choice, but I could be so wrong.
Okay, you know, I'm going number three as Aligoté. I could literally argue with myself for another hour of which one's Aligoté.
The Aligoté is number two, wine number two, this thing here, because it is the most unusual of the three and I don't drink a lot of Aligoté, so there's my guess, but let's see how the boys went. G'day guys, how did you go with them?
I loved them.
Really? I'm glad someone did.
I really liked all of the wines, yeah. I started off very strong and then it kind of tapered.
I went number two just because it was the weirdest tasting one and Aligoté's weird.
Mm-hmm. I think if out of the three wines, it's gotta be these two. I ummed and ahed about these.
Same.
But I just went with that one. Like, this is the least varietally typical, so it must be Aligoté.
See, I'm feeling good about my guess then because that Chardonnay I've declared. Alrighty, let's start out with wine number one, which we don't think is Aligoté. What do you think it might have been though?
Chenin. Yeah, it had this like candied pineapple, like peach Zappo, like confectionery thing, custard apple. Oh, so good. So good. I'm all into that.
I've always struggled to identify Chenin, and I'm really sort of like, there's something, you know, when something clicks in your head,
yeah,
and you're like, I reckon I know it now. And I'm like, yeah, as soon as I taste it, I'm like, I'm seeing it, I know what it is, I want to call it, it's 100% Chenin. So I'm really glad you are, because you're amazing at picking it.
Yeah, it's my shit. Yeah. Chenin's my shit.
But I think I've encountered
Chenin
this
and Yarra Valley Pinot, that's my special skill.
I reckon I'm gonna do a power move.
Here we go.
I reckon I know the wine.
Okay.
Ooh, go on.
I reckon that's Sigurd.
Ooh, interesting. Yeah, good shout. Yeah, okay, interesting.
That is really amazing.
Good.
That is such a classic. Amazing wine.
Yeah, I hated it. $35, $45, how much was it, Locke?
Hey. Good value, though.
I like that.
That's
yeah,
good value.
And what was it?
Dude.
Oh, dude. Well done.
There it is.
And the wine itself.
Really good stuff.
That is such a good wine.
Oh
mate.
Scrumptious.
It still sucks.
And it is Chenin?
Yes, Chenin. Is that Barossa or the
Barossa Valley?
Yeah, okay.
Clare Valley, yeah. Barossa Valley.
Oh yeah, because I've tasted his straight Clare stuff and it's really good. But yeah, I know he does Barossa stuff too. That's fucking sick.
Great job.
I'm buying.
Good
that.
To be back.
Good to be back. Great call by you. Wine number two.
Okay, yep. Here we go.
I didn't like this either, but I thought it was Aligoté.
I had a call on the other two ones, not as extensive as this, but I called wine number two Muscadet and wine number three Aligoté.
Yeah,
it smells like bait cockles.
That's actually good. Really interesting. That's such a good great taster for Muscadet.
You said not Aligoté.
I think Muscadet is a really good shout.
Cool.
I think that's what I did also call as well.
Aligoté, 1 for 30.
6 for 50?
6 for 38.
38. Lucky, how much was it?
Hey,
nailed nicely
it.
Done.
That's actually Aligoté pricing too.
Come on.
Give me that shit.
No!
What you need to understand about tasting Aligoté Blanc is that when you get that sort of, I've been on the back of a boat, the cockers have been sitting in the sun for 3 hours, and my dad's yelling at me because I missed the last fish. That's Aligoté, baby. But yeah, no, this was my favorite of the three, but even still, I only wanted 3 bottles, $40.
This was my second favorite, 12 bottles for 48.
3 bottles for 35, wasn't that particularly interested. I thought this was my Muscadet thingy.
What it cost? 34.
Okay.
34.
Hey.
Sounds like another Aligoté.
Yeah.
Close.
Rioja. You know what's really, really interesting in my tasting? I actually was like, this reminds me of like really textural whites out of like Spain and Portugal.
Mm. Yeah, absolutely.
100%. 100%. Yeah, wow.
2018, bit of age on it.
Really impressive white out of Spain, to be honest.
This just isn't my style of white wine that I like drinking. Mm-hmm. It's not sweet enough or buttery enough.
I seem to recall there being some kind of debt that has to be paid for those who hit the Aligoté button.
No shit.
And you just won. You just won.
I think there was about $15 in the pot, and I think 10 of that was put in by me, so I'm happy to call it even.
Yeah, sweet, I got out scot-free. I never,
yeah, you never called it.
But and I never will.
The Aligoté bell has been rung. Thank you very much for watching. Thank you to Different Drop for supplying the wines, and we'll catch you in the next one, guys. Bye.
Ciao.